this morning to speak to every one of us, that he will touch us where we need him most. Shall we begin to pray? Tell him, today being the first day of another month, we give you praise because life is a privilege. We thank you because you have given it to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. As we go into your word this morning, we pray. Baba, you will speak to every one of us. You will touch us and change us where we need you most in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you because you have answered. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Kindly have your seat. We want to bless the name of the Lord this morning for giving us the grace to be here in his presence. And I thank him for this opportunity to be here to speak the word of the Lord. And at the same time, my gratitude goes to my father in the law, the authority of this campus. And my father's in the Lord up here for this opportunity they have given me to come out to the front to speak the word of God. And I pray for you, Baba, that God will continue to make you better and greater and more wonderful in the ministry that he has called you into.
Amen.
Well, the topic given to me this morning is the sacrifices and the rewards of soul winning. The sacrifices and the reward of soul winning. We will recall that we have been looking at evangelism and soul winning this time around. And my fathers in the Lord who are giving us the word of the Lord, they have done a lot of justice to the theme. And so they have given me this opportunity to share this aspect of a message. That is to look at what it will cost us and what we stand to benefit when we do the work of soul winning. Philippians chapter 2 verses 5 to 11, that is one of the texts that I have here. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in the fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. And wherefore, God also hath rightly exalted him, highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Then the second one, that is at Philippians also, chapter 3. Read from verses 7 to 14. Philippians chapter 3. Verses 7 to 14. Paul the apostle speaking there says, but what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. Yet, doubtless, I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ, and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death, if by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
From the topic that I have before me, three key words stand out there. The first one is sacrifices. And then the second one is rewards. And the third one is soul winning. And if we look at the three of them together, we will discover that there is something to be paid as a price for winning something. There is a sacrifice to be made before we will get the reward. And it means that we have to do that so that we may do the work for which God has called us, which is so winning. Now, sacrifice means giving away something valuable to get at least something that is of equal value or something more, or to avoid a loss. It can also mean giving an offering to a deity. So if we look at the 2 minutes that I've given here, whether we offer something to a deity or we offer something very valuable so that we may gain something more valuable, we'll see the definition as quite being in place. And the reward, the result of an action. A price obtained after something has been done. A price obtained after something has been done. Or something of value given in return for an action or an act.
So
if we look at the two of them, you see sacrifice costing us more and the reward are coming to us as a result of our sacrifice. And on that premise is the job that God has committed into our hands. That is the job of soul winning. So that means if we will be soul winners indeed, we have something or some things to sacrifice and to get certain things. But it takes a conviction to sacrifice. We have to be convinced of what we are working for, or of what we are aiming at before we sacrifice. You know what you want, you know what you desire, you know what you are after, then you are convinced of it, then you sacrifice anything for it. And the matter of the kingdom of God, of bringing souls to the kingdom of God, is of that great value that Jesus said the kingdom of God is like a man who discovered a treasure in the field.
Iṣẹ́ ìjìnlẹ̀ ọkàn jẹ́ iṣẹ́ tó ní olórí gan gidi gan. Èyí ni Jésù ṣe àkàwé rẹ̀ nínú òwe rẹ̀ wípé ìjọba ọ̀run ó dàbí ọkùnrin kan tó rí ìṣúra nínú oko rẹ̀.
And to be able to get in possession of that treasure, he had to go back and sell all that he had and come back to purchase it.
Kí ó bá lè ní ìṣúra yìí gbà, ó lọ sílé, ó ta ohun gbogbo tó ní láti wá rí ìṣúra yìí rà.
And if you look at that parable, that means that person was convinced, he was passionate, you know, he actually passionately desired what he wanted.
Tẹ bá wo òwe yẹn, a rí pé ẹni yẹn ó ní ìdánilójú tó ó mọ ohun tó ń fẹ́ gbà yẹn, ó sì ní ìtara láti gbà á.
The same way we should carry ourselves, or we, the same way we should be passionate and know about winning souls, giving it all that it takes.
Bákan náà ni ó yẹ kí àwa náà ní ìtara àti ìlépa àti jèrè ọkàn láti a gbọ́dọ̀ fi ohun gbogbo tí ó ní gbà fún.
I know, I remember the story of a particular criminal.
Mo rántí ìtàn ọ̀daràn kan.
He was about to be executed.
Ó kù díẹ̀ kan pa.
And the priest was invited to come and preach to him.
Wọ́n sì ní kí àlùfáà kan wá gbà wá wàásù fún.
And when he came, he was telling him to give his life to Christ.
Nígbà tó wọ́n sọ pé fi ayé rẹ̀ fún Kristi.
Because lay down before him and all was heaven and hell.
Níwájú rẹ̀ ni ọ̀run rere àti ọ̀run àpáàdì dúró.
I was telling him that if he didn't give his life to Christ, he will soon be executed and will end up in hell fire.
Pé tí o bá fayọ̀ rẹ̀ fún Jésù, wọn ò lè pẹ́ pa, yóò sì parí sí ọ̀run àpáàdì.
He went ahead to describe how terrible the place called hell was.
Ó sì tẹ̀síwájú láti ṣàlàyé bí ọ̀run àpáàdì ṣe burú tó.
And then the criminal looked at him in the face.
Ọ̀daràn yẹn wojú rẹ̀.
And I said, priest.
Alufa.
If you know this thing,
to ba mo kini,
and you are so convinced about it,
to si da o loju gan.
Well, I think you should have been more concerned about it. No, giving me the gospel before I ended up here.
O ba ti fun mi ni rere yi ko to di pe mo de bi ti mo de yi duro ko to wa.
Because the criminal got to know him, he knew him as a gentle priest who will not harm anyone, who will not harm any fly, will go about his normal business, and then would live, you know, his life like a saint where he was placed. But he was the kind of passion, the kind of conviction that he was supposed to exhibit to be able to convince somebody who was a sinner. The criminal did not see it in him.
Ọ̀daràn yìí ti mọ àlùfáà tẹ́lẹ̀ rí gẹ́gẹ́ bí ènìyàn jẹ́jẹ́ kò lè pa iṣin lára tó ń gbégbé ayé rẹ̀ ṣùgbọ́n kò ní ìtara láti wàásù fún ọ̀daràn kó tó di àkókò yìí.
So by inference I would say the priest was not able to do away with his time, to do away with his money, to do away with his pleasure, to do away with things that were so dear to him. So the time came to preach and he came like a gentleman to preach to him. The man was not convinced. Said, if you had known all these things, why haven't you told me all this why?
Ohun tó jọ lójú mi ni pé àlùfáà yìí kò lè ná àkókò rẹ̀, owó rẹ̀ tàbí ìtara rẹ̀ láti lè jèrè ọkàn yìí. Ó ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wá ń bọ̀ ní ìsinyìí. Ọ̀daràn yẹn ò gbà.
The priest knew it.
Àlùfáà yìí mọ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀.
But he seemed he was not ready to sacrifice.
Ṣùgbọ́n kò ṣetán láti fi ìrúbọ.
And he was glad to tell him the story of heaven and hell.
Ó wá lọ síbẹ̀ láti sọ ìtàn ọ̀run àpáàdì àti ọ̀dún rere fún.
And so he missed that opportunity.
Ó sọ àǹfààní yìí nù.
Because the criminal was not convinced of the Lord Jesus Christ he was preaching to him.
Nítorí pé ìwàásù yìí kò dá ọ̀daràn yìí lójú nípa Jésù.
So before we will say we want to sacrifice and give everything I know that it takes to bring souls to Christ, it means we have to be convinced, we have to be passionate, we have to be we have to carry ourselves into it.
Kátóró fi gbogbo tí a nílẹ̀ fún ìjèrè ọkàn, ó gbọ́dọ̀ dá wa lójú, a gbọ́dọ̀ fi ìtara sí i kí a lè jèrè ọkàn.
Because no sacrificing will require at least three things from us.
Ìrúbọ yóò gba nǹkan mẹ́ta pàtàkì lọ́wọ́ wa.
The first thing that it will require is the spirit of love.
Ìkíní ni ẹ̀mí ìfẹ́.
If you look at the example of Jesus Christ, the Bible says, and God himself the Father, in John chapter 3 verse 16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave.
Tẹ bá wo dáadáa rí i pé Ọlọ́run fúnra rẹ̀ Bíbélì wí nínú ìwé Jọ̀hánù orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ kẹrìndínlógún pé Ọlọ́run fi aráyé tó bẹ̀ gẹ́ tó fi ọmọ rẹ̀.
So if the love of God is not there in our heart, to sacrifice will be difficult.
Tí ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run yẹn ò bá sí nínú ọkàn wa àti irúbọ ò lè ó máa nira.
We also need to have the spirit of mercy.
A tún gbọ́dọ̀ ní ẹ̀mí àánú.
Because if you do not have it, it will be difficult for you to sacrifice.
Ati nitori pe o ba ni emi anu yo ni olara lati le se irubo.
In Matthew chapter 5 verse 7 the Bible says blessed are the merciful for they shall receive mercy.
Matthew ori karun ese keje pe alabukunu fun ni awon laanu tori won ra anu gba.
We all want to make heaven.
Gbogbo ala fe de orun.
We want forgiveness for our sins.
Gbogbo ala fe darije ise.
And we want to rest with the Lord in eternity.
Ati simi pelu Olorun lai lai.
And then we have received the grace and we are already born again.
Ati ni ore ofe gba si ti di atunbi.
But we are not merciful enough to those who are yet to be born. We can tell them the story of heaven and hell. But their lives and all the precious souls that will be lost forever, that will be irredeemable, you know, will not touch us. We just want to say it because God has said, go ahead and say it. We also require the spirit of death because we are indebted to God. In Romans chapter 1:14-15, Paul says that he sees himself as a debtor to the Greek and to the Jews.
Ninu Rome ori kini ese kerin la titi de ikedogun Paul wi pe oun je ajigbese si awon Jew ati elegun.
And I dare say that every Christian, every minister of God called into this ministry is a debtor. You are bound to pay the debt by bringing souls to Christ.
Nítorí náà mo sọ pé gbogbo ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run tí a pè sínú iṣẹ́ pátápátá jẹ́ ajigbèsè, a sì gbọdọ̀ san gbèsè yẹn nípa mímú ọkàn wá bá Jésù.
So you have been bought at a price.
A fi iye kan ra wá.
And then you are also given a job to do.
A sì fún wa ní iṣẹ́ láti ṣe.
Because the price over you has been paid.
Nítorí iye wa láti san.
And actually as a token of that, I know, appreciation to God, you need to go out and bring others to
Christ.
So, but why do we have to sacrifice? Because number one, because God commanded it.
Nítorí pé Ọlọ́run pa láṣẹ ìdí àkọ́kọ́.
Number one, God commanded it.
Ìdí àkọ́kọ́ Ọlọ́run ló pa láṣẹ.
When we say it is a command.
Nígbà tá a pè ní àṣẹ Ọlọ́run.
It means it must be obeyed.
Ìyẹn ni pé a gbọ́dọ̀ gbọ́ràn sí.
It means if we do not obey it.
Ìyẹn tá ò bá gbọ́ràn sí.
So we will face the consequence.
A ó dojú kọ ìdí ohun tí ó ti bẹ̀ jáde wá.
It is a command.
Àṣẹ ni.
Our watchword in Mark this year in Mark chapter 16:15.
Akọ́mọ̀nà wa ní ọdún yìí ní Mákò orí ìkẹrìndínlógún ẹsẹ̀
karùndínlógún. What does it say?
Kí ló sọ?
It says go ye into the world. That is a command.
Ó sọ wọn pé ẹ lọ láti gbàsù fún gbogbo ọkàn.
So if he has commanded us to go.
Tó bá ti pa láṣẹ fún wa nígbà náà pé kí a lọ.
It means we have to go.
Ó di ìyẹn ni pé ó di dandan kí a lọ.
Two.
Ìkejì.
Sacrifice the job that we have before us also required sacrifice.
Iṣẹ́ tí ó wà ní ọwọ́ wa nílò ìrúbọ.
It is a task that cannot be executed without sacrificing.
Iṣẹ́ tí a kò lè ṣe láì rúbọ ni.
We have to spend all so that we may get all.
A gbọ́dọ̀ ná gbogbo rẹ̀ kí a bá lè jèrè gbogbo rẹ̀.
The Bible makes us to understand.
Ìbéèlì mú kó yé wa.
That the job before, like the parable I just mentioned, that the job before us, we need to sell all to get all.
Iṣẹ́ tó wà níwájú wa gẹ́gẹ́ bí òwe tí a gbọ́, a gbọ́dọ̀ ta gbogbo rẹ̀ kí a bá lè ra gbogbo rẹ̀.
Number one, we have to go to where sinners are.
A gbọ́dọ̀ jáde lọ síbi tí àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ wà ní àkọ́kọ́.
Most times sinners are not located in our comfort zone.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ níbi tí a gbà yẹn a kò rí àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀.
Therefore, the job requires that we go to them.
Iṣẹ́ yẹn ni pé kí a jáde lọ bá wọn.
And another thing is that these people we call sinners that are yet to come to Christ, they are not willing, most of the time they are not willing to come to us.
Ìkejì ni pé àwọn ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ tí ó yẹ kó wá kí sọ̀rọ̀ Jésù wọn ṣetán láti wá.
So we have to go finding them out.
Àwa ni a gbọ́dọ̀ lọ máa wá wọn káàkiri.
And most times not where we will naturally want to be.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà kì í ṣe ibi tí a ó wù wá láti lọ ni a ó ti rí wọn.
Let's remember the time the white missionaries came to Africa.
Ìrántí ìgbà tí àwọn ajínrere òyìnbó wá sí orílẹ̀-èdè yìí.
Most of them left at the time industrial revolution was on in Europe.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wọn kúrò lọ́hùn nígbà tí orílẹ̀-èdè wọn gbèrú sí.
When life seemed to be better.
Nígbà tí orílẹ̀-èdè wọn ní owó sí.
Even before then, life was much better than it was in Africa.
Ní ọ̀dọ̀ wọn lọ́wọ́ ìgbé ayé wọn níbẹ̀ yẹn ìlú wọn dára ju orílẹ̀-èdè Africa lọ.
They didn't stay there hoping that one day Africa will come to them to receive the gospel.
Wọ́n jókòó sí ìlú wọn kan ní àwọn Africa wà bá wa lọ́jọ́ kan láti wá gba ìrírí.
So they saw that the nature of the job in hand require that they left their places and come down to this place.
So they left
their countries, they left their cities, they left their good houses to come to the African
jungle.
Then, number three, because it certainly brings rewards.
In Matthew
chapter
19, 29,
Jesus said, if you will leave fathers, mothers, sisters, brothers, you sacrifice those people and those things for the sake of Christ. He says that you shall inherit everlasting life and you will receive hundredfold of those things that you have left for Christ's sake.
O wi pe bi enikeni ma fi baba iya omo ati ile sile nitori tohun yo gba ire re ni aye yi ni ogogoran ati ni aye to nbo.
So because it is God's command, we have to sacrifice.
Nitori pe ase Olorun na gboro se irubo won.
Because it the job requires sacrifice, we have to offer it.
Nitori pe ise yi nilo irubo, a gboro se irubo.
And because it brings rewards, it brings fruit, it cannot fail when we do it rightly. Then we have to do it.
Nitori pe o mu ere wa o di dandan ki a se.
So what do we have to sacrifice?
Kini a nilo lati fi rubo?
May I say anything that it requires?
Mo le so pe gbogbo n ti yo na wa.
No, it will require our comfort zone.
Yo na wa ni itura wa.
From the text that we read,
ninu bi ti aka,
we have seen the example of Jesus Christ.
Ari apere Christi.
The Bible says he didn't count it robbery to be equal with God.
Kori gege bi jibiti pe ki o fi ara re gege bi Olorun.
So that was his comfort zone in heaven. No, he had the glory, he had the praise of angels to enjoy every day, every hour. But he left that place and condescended to this, our low estate, putting on the nature of man. And the Bible says we saw him in the image of a servant.
Oni ogo ati ola ati igbadun iyan wa ngeli lorun sugbon o fi gbogbo ele o wa awari ni iri eniyan ati iri omo odo.
And then they gave himself up, no paying the supreme sacrifice, so that humanity might be redeemed.
Ari pe o san gbese ti o lagbara julo ki iran eniyan ba le ri igbala.
So he paid it all, he left his comfort zone.
O san gbogbo gbese na, o fi agbegbe itura re sile.
Now when we look at the example of Paul also,
te ba wa pere Paul na,
things that were gained to him, he abandoned for Christ's sake.
Only until Jerry phone won't feel left from Christy.
He abandoned for Christ's sake.
Oh, if you want to see left from Christy.
So whether it was reputation, he abandoned it. Whether it is self-esteem, he abandoned it. Or big money that will accrue to him from what he professed and what he went about doing, he left all those things. So he left his big job or big business to come and give his life and service to this savings of souls. The best of his time, the best of his belongings, everything he abandoned. Family members and also he left, and friends and acquaintances, he left them. But are we ready to do the same thing today? Are we ready to do the same thing today?
Yeah, wa se tan lati se be loni.
One man said in his message some time ago and I heard it.
He said
for us Christians or ministers of God, we like to say, okay, God has called us, we will do the work of God. And then when the matter comes to the place of sacrifice and God takes up his knife to cut us and laying us on the altar and to land the knife on us, we say, God, sorry, I can't endure the knife, let me go.
Because sacrifice
is not always easy. Because it will touch you where it will pain you. And we have examples of people who did it, who gave it all. People who had love, the spirit of love, the spirit of mercy, they were passionate, they were concerned, they even wished that God would send them to hell, will remove their names from the book of life so that they my I have others saved.
Ri awon to ni itara ati anu fun ijiro kan de bi pe won ti le so fun Olorun pe Oluwa o ti le ran mi lorun apadi ki awon miran le ndi.
We remember the story of Moses.
Aran ti tan Moses.
And then at the time in Exodus Exodus chapter 32.
Ni Exodus ori kejilelogbon.
Verses 30 to 32.
Ese ogbon si kejilelogbon.
Moses even told God.
Moses so fun Olorun.
Now if you will not carry these people to the promised land.
To ba ni mu awon eyan le de ile leri.
If you will destroy them here where they have sinned.
So ba pa won run ni bi ton ti dese yi.
I'm only asking that you grant them mercy and you pardon their iniquity.
Ah mo nbe o pe ko dare ese won ji won ko sanu fun won.
Alternatively, blot my name out of your book of life.
Mo oruko mi kuro ninu iwe re.
Let me perish so that they might have life.
Je ki n segbe ki awon le niye.
And God was so touched.
Olorun o wa kan Olorun.
God changed his mind.
Olorun yi okan re pada.
God said, go ahead, go and lead them to the promised land.
Olorun ni okay, mo won lo sile lori.
I will go with you.
Ma ba Olo.
Because God saw the sincerity of the heart of Moses.
Nitori Olorun ri itara kan Moses.
And he was ready to give it all.
O si setan lati gbogbo re lile.
Paul the apostle also said the same thing.
Paul apostle na so bakan na.
Concerning the Jews.
Nipa awon Jew.
He didn't say bamu bamu ni ohun yo. Ko mo pe ebi npa enikankan.
He did not fear or concern.
Though they rejected the gospel that he preached to them.
Won ko irere to won asu fun won looto.
But he wished that God would count him a cast away so that the Jews might be saved.
O wu pe bi Olorun ti ele ta ohun ki awon Jew le ri pada.
So that we might see the extent of the love that he had for the people of for his people, the Jews.
Kale ri iye itara ti o ni fun awon ara Jew.
And David said, because some people did not love your word, because they have abandoned your word, he said he shed tears.
And nitori pe awon eniyan ti gba pe Olorun o bu sekun.
Psalm 119 verse 136.
Psalm ori kokandini ogofa.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we have seen the example of Jesus Christ.
Atiri apare Jesus.
The author and the finisher of our faith.
Olupelesi ati alajite
gbogbo wa. Who gave it all?
En to fi gbogbo re sile.
As we read it in our text.
Yabe ki abi sheka nibi ti akọ.
And in John chapter 15 verse 3 it says, I laid down my life.
John ori kedogun ni o ti so pe mo fi aye mi lile.
John 15:13.
John ori kedogun ese ketala.
Then the good shepherd laid down his life.
Oluṣagun to to fi aye re lile.
And when we look at history also.
Jaba wo ninu itan.
Especially in Africa.
Ni orilede Africa.
We must have heard about names like Livingstone.
O ti gbo oruko okunrin ti a daruko
ni. A man that so much loved Africa and there was a willing that they would come to the knowledge of Christ.
Eni ti o feran orilede Africa. Gidigidi pe kun le wa simo Christi.
Africa was in his heart was in Africa.
Okan re wa ni Africa, Africa wa ni okan re.
And I read that even when he was about to die, he said, even after he's dead, his heart should be buried in Africa.
O so gan nigba ti o kun pe won lati sinku ni Africa.
Believing that would be a point of attraction to God to save Africa.
Pe eleyi o je nti o fa okan Olorun lati ba Africa la.
And we will remember our own Babalolas.
A o tun ranti baba Babalola na.
We will remember our own Akinyele.
A o ranti baba Akinyele na.
We will remember our own Odubanjos.
A o ranti baba Odubanjos
na. We know without their sacrifice, CAC will not be what it is today.
I'm paid like see rubo one ijo CAC o le ijin to da loni.
They sacrifice their time.
Won lo won fi akoko won
rubo. They sacrifice their family life.
Won fi gbe aye family
dile won. They sacrifice their land.
Won lo won fi le won rubo.
And they gave it all it took so that they might spread the gospel of Christ and bring souls to Christ.
Won yonda gbogbo nti yo na won lati le wasu ire Christi.
But what